know that you are a songwriter as well, and can you tell us about In the End that you just wrote for the administration album with them?
Yeah, sure. I'll tell you the whole story about that. I actually wrote another song called Last Time Around with him. Keep on moving like you did last summer when the grass was green. And yeah, it's yeah, no, thank you. We wrote it both in the same day. Mm-hmm. Nick, I guess you know the story. Nick, like, went to Nashville for 8 days and did this whole album. Like pretty much the day before he left, he still was like working on some last minute songs, I guess. And so he just called me up. We went to a studio, and we just like sat there for 13 hours and we pumped out 3 songs. And In the End is about something that he had gone through. Mm-hmm. Baby, it all comes back to haunt you. And then we just, like, he was actually going through it at the time, and then I said, well, why don't we just write a song about it? Like, we were just talking about it, and then we used it as inspiration for a song. I'll let him tell what it's about. But, yeah, it was, and then Last Time Around came out, like, at 1 in the morning, right before we left. We just, like, wrote that one. That was fun, and,
got that leaf here. Interesting.
Yeah, so I'm like, I was honored to be a part of it. I'm honored that he called me. And it's like always a good time writing with him. And I didn't know he was going to cover tonight either. That was like not part of the plan.
I'm excited about that.
Yeah.
I like the slow version. It's really nice.
I do too.
That's kind of the way we had originally written it. And then we played it for John Fields, their producer, and we said, he basically was like, this can go either, you know, either way, like it could be a really, a big ballad, or it can be like an up-tempo, you know, like kind of techno-y song. And so we messed around with it and then decided to go the way that it is, but I think it's really good as a ballad too. I think it works both ways.
What was your inspiration on Last Time Around? What was the inspiration to that song?
Man, I don't even remember. We had been writing for so long that day. We wrote another song that's not on the album. I don't know, we might get used to or something. But, I don't know, it was just kind of like came out at the last minute. I started out by playing that riff. I think Nick was playing it, and then I played like some chords over it that is now the intro to the song, and then it just kind of wrote itself. And sometimes you can work on a song for several days, and then sometimes it just comes out in like an hour. And that was one of those, like, it just, I think we had just finished it. We wrote like that last like guitar riff that the song ends with, and then we were just like, let's just go home. Like, we didn't even, I was like, are you gonna remember this tomorrow? He's like, I'll remember it. I was like,
Where do you see yourself in 2020?
In 2009?
No, in 10 years.
10 years?
2020. Yeah.
That is
watching this YouTube video.
There we go.
Being like, man, 10 years.
Putting
like,
in the time capsule.
Man, I was so dumb. No, I'm just joking.
Do your best Nick or Joe or Kevin voice.
I don't know. Well, my favorite is when Nick, he'll just kind of like stare at the crowd sometimes. Because, you know, he's taking things in after like a little bit longer or something. And he'll just kind of stare at the crowd for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
That's cool. And he also, he'll admit this too, he talks like with a southern accent when he's on stage. I noticed it again last night at his show. Just like, yeah, just like, all right, now this next song I'm about to do for you. And it's funny because he never talks like that unless he's holding a guitar. Yeah. I'm so proud of him watching that show. So good.
Big older brother feeling.
So talented, yeah. Like, all that falsetto, like, his guitar solos, the songwriting. I'm like, yeah, really happy I got to go.
Mm-hmm.
Really impressed with him.
That's cool. Hoffman.
Hoffman, yes. That did work out. Bob Hoffman, we affectionately call him Bob, is this Jonas Brothers photographer. He and I have been friends since we were 10 years old. We were on the same Little League team. His dad was the coach. I think my dad was like an assistant type coach.
Cool.
And we went to middle school, high school together. We were sweet mates in college. And I can brag about him for a little bit. He interned with Annie Leibovitz, who's a super, super like well-known and great photographer.
Yeah.
And he just came out and took some photos for fun of the Jonas Brothers one day. And then I showed him to their manager, and he was like, wow, it's awesome. And so he came out. He's really, really talented. He took all the photos in that book, Burn It Up. And yeah, all the press photos and stuff. Yeah, he's really, really good, and he's like one of my oldest friends. And it's his birthday today.
Happy birthday, Hoffman.
He's 24.
So what weird things does he do? Weird tidbits you were talking about.
He's a great writer. That's not that weird, but he's like a really, really talented, like artistic, not only with the camera, but with writing too. Mm-hmm. He's a really good writer. I don't know, like, I can't think of anything now. Like, maybe like right as tour ended, I could have done maybe some more mm-hmm. funny things, but yeah, he's just a hilarious guy. I really like him. Yeah. Good friend.
For rainy or sunny days?
Well, from New Jersey, so the gray sky is something I like. Like when it's just super overcast, there's something nostalgic about it. But I live in LA now, and like it's beautiful all the time, so I like the sunny days too. I can appreciate both. Again, just bad answer, but I like, you know. And then again, I should say it rained all last week and it was not fun.
Yeah.
In LA, so I prefer a sunny day, I should say.
Speaking of Jersey, do you watch Jersey Shore?
It seems like very popular show. I've seen one episode of the Jersey Shore, and I grew up going to Ortley Beach every summer. Uh-huh. My family, my grandparents used to have a house there, and it filmed in Seaside Heights, which is right next door. And yeah, they, you know, you stalk my entire life on the boardwalk. That's my situation, or my Pauly D, whatever.
Yeah,
their name.
It's your best actor. Yeah. It's a situation.
Yeah, no. No, those are my people. Those are my people. Yeah, I need to get some hair gel, I think. New Jersey, you come out of the womb doing the fist pump.
Come out of the womb.
Techno music.
It's techno music.
Yeah, it's just kind of ingrained in you. It's really bizarre. It's a weird subculture, right?
Yeah.
But like, it's like, I guess that show is like such a shock to a lot of people, but it's like, I just grew up like knowing a ton of people like that. So
really? A lot of people like that are, I mean, from Jersey are,
yeah,
like that?
I mean, I am. When I'm not on tour with the Jonas Brothers, I have my hair like that, and
you're,
yeah,
a situation.
I'm a situation.
Situation, very cool.
I'm a big situation.
Okay.